screaming down.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
He said, we can picture our Lord now having been nailed to that old rugged cross. Mm-hmm. Broken and bruised. Mm-hmm. Blood streaming down from everywhere.
Jesus.
Having been beaten with a cat of nine tails.
Mm-hmm. Jesus.
Which is iron and bone wrapped up in almost time. Saints, even when his disciples left him, I heard Peter when he said, I'll never leave you. I hear somebody in here saying, I'll never leave you. But then they go right out the door and they leave him in their attitude, their personality, the way they handle their brothers and sisters, the way you talk to somebody.
Yes.
Oh, I'll never leave you, Lord. I'll be with you to the end. Unless somebody says something wrong to you. Mm-hmm. Let things don't go your way.
Come on. Amen.
Let that wife don't have it right when she gets home.
Yeah.
Let her husband say something out of the way.
Yes.
That's fighting words. Mm-hmm. If not of that, we're going to get a divorce.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Jesus.
He didn't say, Boaz, why have you forsaken me?
He was nailed to the cross the third hour, which is about 9 o'clock in the morning.
Nine.
But he did not utter, it is finished,
right,
until the ninth hour,
right,
until about 3 p.m.
Uh-huh.
He did not finish speaking until after he had assured that all was accomplished.
Yeah. Yeah.
He could not stop doing anything he was doing until after every I had been dotted.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Until after every T had been crossed. Before every jot. And until every tittle had been accomplished.
Mm-hmm.
Before it was finished. Before he said it was finished.
Uh-huh.
He had to set an example to mankind.
Yeah.
That you must care one for another.
That's right.
Yeah.
Jesus has spent 3 years ministering to God's people. Healing and teaching. But even if can't go yet,
yes,
it ain't finished yet. I have to forgive somebody.
Amen.
I want you to know, Deacon Campbell. Want you to know, Brother Sean. Before you close your eyes, you gotta learn to forgive everybody, not just those that love you, not just those that care about you, even those that hate you and despitefully use you.
Yes.
It ain't finished until you can say, "I forgive them."
Yes.
Yeah, they talked about me. Yeah, they lied on me.
Yeah.
But it ain't finished.
Yes.
Before it could be finished, he had to stop dying on the cross.
Jesus.
He had to reach out for one more soul.
Yeah.
That sinner that was on his right hand.
Yeah.
That sinner that needed somebody to speak a word of life to him.
Yes.
Yes.
Jesus thought he was done. Jesus had healed so many. He even brought one back from the dead named Lazarus.
Yeah.
He even touched the bride of Jairus' daughters.
Yes.
Who was already dead and brought her back to life.
Yes.
Right.
But before it was finished, Jesus had to look to his right and had the same one more soul. He had hoped in his heart that he could also look to his left and take that one into paradise too. But that one did not look up.
Yeah.
Come on.
Like Evangelist said, that one didn't recognize who he was.
Yeah.
Like Brother Roshan talked about.
Yeah.
That one could not be saved. Because he didn't want to be saved. But Jesus said, I'm going to get one more before I go. It ain't finished yet. And then Jesus kept on. And he said it was almost time for him to commit his spirit to the Lord. But he remembered that it ain't finished until every word of God, every jot and every tittle had been fulfilled.
Amen.
And so he remembered over there in the Old Testament, it was prophesied that they will give me guile for my meat.
Uh-huh.
And in my thirst, they will give me vinegar to drink.
Mm-hmm.
So Jesus looked down at those who were crucifying him and said, I thirst.
Yes.
He wasn't thirsty, y'all.
Uh-huh.
He only said, I thirst because all the scriptures had to be fulfilled.
Yes.
And before all the scriptures could be fulfilled, he had to get them to give him vinegar.
Uh-huh.
And then he can say, it is finished. I want you to know today and today all of God's word has been accomplished in your life.
Yes.
All the things that God has spoken to you about, the things that he's called you to do, you cannot commit your spirit to God. You cannot lay down and give up the ghost until God has come and spoken and you have fulfilled his every word. It is finished.
Yes.
But I want you to know that even though Jesus said it was finished, he was only talking about a phase of his life.
Uh-huh.
He was talking about that pre-crucifixion message that he had to bring, the teachings that he had to do. He was only talking about this earthly mission here on earth.
Uh-huh.
But I want you to know it ain't over yet. Fat lady has not yet sung. It ain't over till it's over. And I've come today to let you know that it ain't finished. Jesus died on Calvary cross, but he arose again because he realized it ain't finished yet. He realized that there was an angel that needed to be saved. Realized there was a you and there was a me that yet had to be reached. It ain't finished yet. God still got some healing in the alabaster box. God still got some deliverance in the palm of his hand. God still got a way to make out of no way in your life. It ain't finished yet. Jesus is sitting up in heaven now, peeping over heaven's throne, looking at your needs.
Come on.
Looking at my needs. Looking at Connecticut's needs. Looking at Sam's needs. Looking at the knees of God's people.
Yes, Lord. Jesus
know it ain't finished yet. That host of angels that could have come and rescued him from the crucifixion, brought him from the cross, that same host of angels is seen being sent down now, letting us know it ain't finished.
Amen.
God still got some work to do.
Yes,
God still got some deliverance to bring out.
Yes.
And God wants you to know, even in this Good Friday, that even though he died, it ain't finished.